A new twist tonight into Australia's housing affordability crisis. One expert thinks expensive homes may even be stopping us from having children. And a drop in the national birth rate could be because more and more Australians are staying at home to try and save for house deposits. Joe Hill has more.
Julian and Liz wanted to make sure they had the family home sorted out before little Clara came along.
It's very concerning to know whether you can afford both. Yeah, it's always important to make sure you've got the family home set up for everyone.
Well, Clara's now 10 months old and life's pretty great. Things could get a little tricky, though, if she's to have a little brother or sister.
And we've got a fairly small place, it does us, but, yeah, if there's a second kid, the next challenge will be, OK, well, we'll need a bigger house and how are we going to afford that?
For more and more of us, affording a house means moving back in with mum and dad, and that might mean putting off kids.
If you go back a generation, average capital city house price was 5 times average annual earnings. Now it's 10 times average earnings, and so couples are having to delay the family before they can get the home.
As house prices go up, Australia's birth rate is going down. Last year, the average was 1.8 children per woman, compared to 1.88 in 2013. There were around 299,000 births registered in 2014, around 8,000 fewer than the year before.
Couples are going to wait till their early 30s, not their early 20s, to start a family because they can't get that foothold in the property market until later than their own parents did.
It's a case of nest first, nurture later. Joe Hill, 10 Eyewitness News.